Hello and welcome. And this is how to make a journal entry from T accounts. I'm Bennett Tchaikovsky and welcome to my YouTube video. My disclaimer and copyright notice, the information and opinions in this presentation are those of the author only and not the author's employers or affiliated organizations, including but not limited to Irvine Valley College, the South Orange County Community College District, or Chapman University. The presentation is for educational purposes only and does not constitute any legal or accounting advice whatsoever. This presentation is copyright 2008 to 2019 by Bennett Tchaikovsky. I encourage you to share this presentation and share links to this presentation on an unmodified basis. If you modify the presentation in any way, please email me prior to doing so at bennett1812@gmail.com to discuss. Note, I do not claim any copyright whatsoever in any companies or organizations mentioned in this presentation. Rather, the parties are the owners of their respective copyrights. So if you've been following my videos, kind of the way I like to go through and record transactions are using T accounts. And I call this Tchaikovsky's T theory of accounting. Essentially over here, this is telling us how to record transactions. DCERAELOE, Washington DC debit credit, emergency room ER, expenses revenues, AELOE. And the reason why I like doing this is that for you as an accounting student, it's much easier to visualize accounting using T accounts. For instance, here, I record expenses with debits in general. I record revenues with credits, and my assets typically have debit balances. I increase them with debits, decrease them with credits. Liabilities and equity accounts typically have credit balances. I increase those accounts with credit balance with credits, decrease them with debits. So, what is a journal entry? And oftentimes, again, what I have observed in accounting is that often instructors, and it's not their fault, but they'll kind of jump to journal entries really quickly. They're not hard, but if you think about where they really come from, they're really coming from the T accounts. So what exactly is a journal entry? A journal entry is essentially is a shorthand for recording a financial transaction in an accounting system. We can go into QuickBooks and we can create a journal entry. You can look that up online. And you know, when you're doing it in QuickBooks, we're essentially saying, hey, debit cash, credit consulting services revenue. However, in academia, we do journal entries a little bit different. And so the way this is going to be, because when you do QuickBooks, you don't indent the accounts here, but in academia we do, or at least I do in my classes. So here, what you're going through and doing is you're essentially saying, okay, I have a debit here to cash for $800,000. I have a credit here to consulting services revenue. My total debits equal my total credits. And so I'm putting in the date that the transaction happened and then an account description. So this is a typical format for a journal entry. We can look up other examples, and I'm just going to excuse myself to pull up some online. So here's something I just kind of popped up here really quickly. This is accountingbasicsforstudents.com. And right over here, you've got some examples here of some journal entries. Here you've got the debit, you got the credit, and also at the same time here, they're showing the date. There's a description. Here is a folio, which I have no idea what that is, but that could just be some kind of internal reference number. The debits and the credits clearly here that they're essentially being indented. So that's kind of the way that journal entries kind of work. And this is, again, a way of going through and doing it. Mine's a little bit different because when you come over here, I've got my date, account, and then I have my my date account, my debit, and my credit, and then it's to record work performed for a client. So the again, everybody does accounting a little bit differently. This is the way that I do it. Somebody might be doing it differently, but generally this is the proper way to go through and to record a journal entry. So how do we get to the proper form using T accounts? And I want to go back to a question that I did in one of my prior videos, which was on June 15th, 2019, a company receives consulting services from a vendor. The company receives an invoice from the vendor for $50,000 and immediately pays the vendors for the services. The vendor has no further obligations to the company once it's been performed, and we're going to record the transaction using T accounts. So here, I'm paying the company, I'm paying the vendor $50,000 cash. We know that cash is an asset. It's increased with debits and decreased with credits. So here, we're paying cash of $50,000. The consulting services expense right over here is 50 grand. Why is it 50,000 and why is it a debit? I typically record my expenses with a debit. So when I'm going through and doing this, this is why you want to be using T accounts, just because it's going to be making accounting a lot easier for you. So my first step is I'm going to create the T accounts. My second step is, and I'm sure you all love these diagrams, is I'm taking what I just did here and I'm translating it into that kind of form that I was looking at before. So I'm taking consulting services expense, I'm showing this here on the account, and as a debit, remember DC, debit credit. The cash I'm putting underneath this, and note here, it is indented, very, very important. And here I'm showing this as a credit for $50,000. Note here, I do not have a date yet in my transaction and I have no description. All I'm doing is I'm taking what I just went through and did on the T accounts and putting it into this format. My third step is going to be, wow, did I just lose my third step? OMG. Hold on, I'll be right back. Hello, and we're back. Thank you for your patience. And here we go. So, what I've gone through here is I've gone through and taken my T accounts and I put these into essentially this part of the journal entry form. So I've got the consulting services expense. This here is a debit. Remember, DC, basically DC. And then here, my cash is showing as a credit. Note the indent to cash. I indent cash because I'm crediting it. So the next step I'm going to be doing is then I'm going to need to do one final thing, or should I say two final things, is I'm adding a date, which here is June 15th, 2019. And then my description, record cash paid for consulting services. Now, when it comes to the description, there's not necessarily a right way to go through and do it. In fact, we do need to write a description. Some of the programs like Connect don't even have it, or they might actually have it now. I think they have a problem though, because there's not one correct way to write it, but it is very important that you write the account description. So we have this right over here. So we have our description, we have our date, and we are done. So that is how to make a journal entry from T accounts. So to practice, what I would like us to do right now is to go through and to practice this on actually going through and creating some T accounts. So I'm just going to copy this over here and put it to my Google Sheet. And so for this question right here, a company purchased equipment valued at $100,000. The company makes a 20% cash down payment and the remaining balance will be placed as a note. So for this one in particular, what I need to do is I'm saying here, okay, let's go through and record what we know. I'm receiving equipment valued at $100,000. To pay for this equipment, what I'm doing is, well, I'm making a $20,000 down payment. How do I know it's 20 grand? $100,000 purchase price, 20% down, or $20,000. So I'm crediting cash for $20,000. And then do my total debits equal my total credits? The answer is no. The remaining balance is going to be placed as a note. Or 100,000 minus that 20,000 or 80,000. Here I'll have a note payable for $80,000. So that's my first step. So I've put these into their respective T accounts. The next thing I need to go through and do is following my previous part is I've got a date, account, debit, and credit. So what I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna say, all right, my equipment had here a debit for $100,000. Remember, debit's on the left, credit's on the right. So that's what we wanna go through and do here. So my next account here that I'm dealing with is cash. So over here, I'm indenting cash because cash is going down. Whenever I have a credit, I need to indent it. How do I know to indent the description? Look what's happening over here. The description has to follow where the numbers are going. Lastly, I've got a credit here to note payable for $80,000. So what we just did there was we followed here. This is really step one. Our step one was recorded into the T accounts. Our step two is to put it into a journal entry form. Lastly, our step three is we need to do two things. We need to do a date, which is going to be December 31st, 2020. And we also need to have a description. And we can call this here to record purchase of equipment. Now, I could also add in some other additional items. I could say, may take a photo of the equipment invoice, put that in there. That can also now go into accounting systems or whatever may have you. But again, this is really important because this is the format that I need to be following when I'm going through and doing a journal entry. So I want to thank you here for joining me today. And remember, journal entries are not horrible. Start with the T accounts. Learn T accounts first. It'll make your life a lot easier. So thank you for joining me today, and I will see you on the next video. Thanks so much.